Hey everyone, it's Scott from Wildlife Inspired. You can also find me on social media or Patreon at Eskies Images or my website, eskiesimages.com. Today we're going to talk about six myths in bird photography. I'll tell you what, let's jump right in. Let's start with myth number six, golden hour. Now, the myth is not that golden hour doesn't exist. It's about the amount of time that it exists at. For most of us in the United States, depending on the time of the year and whether you live in the north or the south, that golden hour could last 15 to 30 or 45 minutes. It's very rarely, if ever, a full hour in the continental United States. So think about that when you're applying this to your photography. Golden hour provides the most desirable light. It's got a special quality to it, and all photographers really covet that light. But if you're under the impression that it lasts a full hour, it may put you at a disadvantage by starting too late in the morning. When I'm shooting golden hour, I'm often shooting early before sunrise in setup, and then waiting for that first 10 to 15 minutes of light on the horizon. That's when you're going to find the light to be at its most desirable. So think about it. Golden hour exists, but it's a lie. Myth number five, in order to be a wildlife photographer, I have to use a tripod. This myth seems to be perpetuated by seeing images of great wildlife photographers out in the field with their tripods, or images of them walking through the field with the tripod on their shoulder. And while the tripod is a part of all photography for wildlife, including birds, I find with birds it's much less important than with other subjects. And here's the reason. Birds tend to move much quicker and change their positions much faster than other forms of wildlife photography. And for that reason, I tend not to use a tripod when I'm out in the field. I'll handhold or use a monopod for the most part. This allows me the ability to change my position quickly, to avoid branches and clutter, or to get down low to the ground. A tripod I find very cumbersome, and it doesn't allow me to change my position relative to the subject. So when I'm out in the field, I tend to use a monopod or handhold, and about 10 to 20% of the time, I probably do find myself on a tripod. And when do I do that? If I'm photographing harriers or eagles, something that might have a lot of downtime in between. If I'm photographing in low light, an owl, certainly would use a tripod in those situations. And occasionally with waterfowl, when I'm in the water, I'll set up a tripod as I'm waiting for the ducks to pass. But for songbirds and shorebirds, I very rarely, if ever, use a tripod. So myth number five, you need a tripod or you have to use a tripod to be a wildlife photographer, may not be the case for bird photography, depending on your style and how you use it. Myth number four, you have to have a clean background on bird portraits. Now this myth has been around for a while, and it's not necessarily that it's wrong. It just depends on your style. Some people prefer to set up perches with far distant backgrounds, and it provides a very homogeneous, very clean, very sterile background. Other people choose to provide backgrounds that might have more colors and patterns and richness. And this tends to happen when you're actually out in the field working and you're looking for backgrounds that include those colors and patterns and textures. Sometimes they happen accidentally and not intentionally. I find that those backgrounds are the most pleasing to me. When I'm out in the field and I'm in the environment and I'm looking for areas that I think are going to work, and I look at the back of the camera or get home to the monitor and I see these beautiful colors and these beautiful patterns in the background that I probably couldn't have even planned myself. So this myth doesn't mean that you can't have clean backgrounds. Certainly part of my portfolio includes that as well. So myth number four about clean backgrounds isn't necessarily a right or wrong. It's a personal preference. And I would encourage all photographers to play around with different types of environments and not get locked into thinking that the only way or the best way is for things to be clean all the time. Myth number three is near and dear to my heart. And the myth is that all bird photographs require feather detail. And I'm putting an image up on the screen now to illustrate a point. I posted this image on social media and I got an unsolicited critique. Somebody started to tell me how bad the image was, and in part it was because it didn't contain feather detail. I laughed a little bit at this, knowing that I was posting an image that had no reason to include feather detail. The smaller you go in frame, the more important things become composition, lighting, and background. feather detail really becomes irrelevant. As you get closer to subjects and you want to include some feather detail, I think it's perfectly appropriate. So on a tight headshot or a portrait, maybe that feather detail comes into play. But to think that every bird picture and every great image that you produce in avian photography requires feather detail is kind of silly. So think about this. What does it mean to you? Is feather detail that important that you'd be willing to sacrifice composition or light, or that you'd be afraid to move a bird small in frame because you'd lose that feather detail? It really is about your style. Again, as you'll see with many of these myths, what works for you? And I always encourage people to explore and try new things, and especially don't get locked into some of these myths. Myth number two, and this is a big one. Always shoot with the light at your back. I've seen several videos on YouTube, especially as I was starting, about my five tips for bird photography, or this is how to shoot birds. And almost all of them said, put the sun at your back. Well, when you do that, you're losing a lot of possibility for creativity, and you lose the ability to explore light in different ways. The advantages for having your sun at the back are this. You'll tend to get less shadows as the light is projected behind the bird from the front to the back, so you don't get light coming from the side putting shadows on the bird itself. You also tend to be able to get better detail on the bird itself as you're getting light hitting it directly. It can also start to become very flat, and it can start to look like a lot of other photography. When you change your position relative to the sun and your subject is exposed at different angles, you can become a lot more creative. I've got some examples up on the screen now of side lighting and back lighting and silhouettes. None of these were taken with the sun at my back. They were all taken with the sun at different angles. And it really allows you to add some diversity to your portfolio and sometimes create images that are a little bit different than everyone else. It can create high contrast. You can get these super, super soft images from the back, and you can get these beautiful shapes from the silhouettes. But you can't do that when the sun's at your back. So myth number two, always shoot with the sun at your back. I challenge it. Last but not least, myth number one, the entire bird has to be in focus. Now, again, beginning photographers will often be told when they're photographing birds that they need to get all of the detail in the bird, meaning tail to tip. From the tip of the bill to the tip of the tail, everything needs to be in focus. This is not my style. My style typically involves a shallow depth of field, especially with songbirds. Let me show you some examples. As you could see in these examples, the eyes are in focus, but the rest of the body isn't. I'll go back to the same philosophy I have with many of these myths. It's not that they're right or wrong. It just means you have to explore beyond it. Should the bird always be in focus? To me, no. Are there times when it should be? Absolutely. A lot of that also depends on your style. There are very talented photographers out there who believe in shooting subjects at f8 at a distance to capture all of the feather detail. I shoot my subjects at 2.8 often, and I shoot them at close range to get a very shallow depth of field. When you're talking about getting the bird in focus, think of it this way. There are different forms of photography for people. We've got street photography, we've got people that do in-studio modeling, and then we have things like boudoir. Now, all of those are different. They're all photographing people, but they're all very different ways. So a street photographer may be inclined to put their subjects in focus. They may be inclined to show a lot of detail in the face, whereas a boudoir photographer may be inclined to shoot a shallow depth of field where the subject has their certain features like eyes and lips in focus, but the rest of the body is soft and out of focus. It doesn't make one right or wrong. It's just a different style. Explore your style. So as I wrap up these myths, I just want to talk about the concept that I hope came through in the video. That is that there's no one way to do anything. And with bird photography, it's no different. The challenge with bird photography is when a lot of people start, they listen to advice from others, and that advice becomes very singular. For example, shoot with the sun at your back. You have to have feather detail. You have to get the whole bird in focus. Don't crop out the feet. Make sure you get the wingtips sharp. Those are all myths that if you believe in, can limit the way you shoot and limit your creative process. I encourage you to think beyond those myths and get out there and try some different things. You'll see with many of these myths, I don't agree with them. I don't shoot the way that those myths are portrayed. That's my style. I encourage you to find your own. So keep experimenting, challenge the status quo, and find your style. I'm Scott Keys from Wildlife Inspired. Thanks for tuning in. Have a great day.